Oh, yeah, I forgot when I switch scenes, I gotta unmute. Just give me a moment. Okay,
good. All right.
Now, let's try that again. Well, let's kick off this stream. So if you're just tuning in, I am Tech Nate, or on here known as Nate1225. I am hosting the live stream for Mr. Rusty Sheriff's Badge. He is going to stream some Resident Evil 7 Biohazard. We're setting for a personal record of his.
And if you're from Japan, it's Biohazard Resident Evil 7, or Biohazard 7 Resident Evil.
This is news to me. Yep. That's interesting.
Yeah, did you know, you didn't know the Resident Evil games in Japan were actually titled Biohazard?
Really?
Yep. So that's why they do it this way. In the States and stuff like that, like I think European country, it's called Resident Evil, and everywhere, you know, everywhere else outside of Japan, but in Japan it's called Biohazard. So they called it Resident Evil 7 Biohazard, so that way in Japan they can call it Biohazard 7 Resident Evil.
That is interesting. All right, well, anyhow, like I said, if you're just tuning in, we are going to do a personal record, or at least that's our goal, is to set a personal record for Mr. Rusty Sheriff's Badge on Resident Evil 7. We're not going to mess around too much. He's going to give a little dialogue quick, and then we're going to jump into it. So I'll hand it over to him.
Yeah. So this is officially my, I believe it's my sixth playthrough of the game. You know, it's relatively easy. It's not terribly difficult. I like how they kind of just basically pulled everything back to their original form with, like, you know, the scares and stuff like that. It's an actual survival horror game again, you know, after, starting the whole action type thing with Resident Evil 4, jumping into 5 and then 6 and stuff like that. They really needed to come back to form, and they did a phenomenal job with this. I wish they would have spent a little more time on, like, puzzles and stuff like that, but if they did that, then I'd have a little more issues with the speed run. So far, my current record, I think, is an hour and 45 minutes, somewhere in that area there. I'm going to try and maybe shave off a few minutes tonight. I'm not going for a world record. I don't really think I can do that on PS4. It looks like the load times are incorporated in your full time, and if you've played it on console, you know the load times are atrocious, so that eats up a lot of time.
Now, just to intervene quick, there might be some established records for each individual console, you think?
Maybe. I don't know. I haven't really looked into it too much. I did check out the current world record. Right now is like a minute and 33. Absolutely fantastic job. We should probably give that dude a shout out for being such a badass. kind of setting the standard for everything. But he plays on PC, it appears. He has a slight, I think, I'm not 100% positive that the load times are actually incorporated in this, but if it is, you know, on PC, if you have a beefy enough rig, then your load times are pretty much nothing. So, I mean, he might have a slight advantage there, but it's not just that makes him fast. It's the way he navigates the menu and stuff like that. It's absolutely bonkers. Like, he knows exactly where every time he picks up an item, it goes into his inventory and stuff like that. It's really impressive to watch. But anyways, this is just going to be a personal record for me. I speedrun every single Resident Evil game ever since the first one came out. I absolutely love this franchise. You know, huge fan, so naturally I just wanted to speedrun this. I was pretty impressed with how short you can actually make it. My first playthrough was like just shy of 10 hours, and now I've got it down to under 2 hours going through it. So in doing that, though, like if we have any new viewers that haven't seen Resident Evil 7 played before, there is a lot of stuff that's cut out in my speed run, obviously, like a lot of story-based things where, you know, you have to, throughout the game, you take phone calls that kind of guide you along. Well, there's a lot of different phone calls you can ignore, a couple that you cannot ignore. So I'll obviously be listening to those ones, but the rest of them you'll kind of miss tidbits of information. Like, you won't really understand, why am I going here to do this? But it's not really about that. Like, if you're here for the story of Resident Evil 7, you're not really going to get it fully. You're going to be kind of confused by the end of it, but, you know.
You'll get the main gist of it, though, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's not much less frightening either, playing it. It actually is quite a quite a scary game. I'm really impressed with that. It's absolutely bonkers in VR, just for the record. I didn't play the entire game in VR because, you know, let's be honest, you know, the VR setup is a little inhibitive. So it's like, if you want to just kick back and relax, you want to sit in front of your TV or chill on the couch and play a game, it's, VR doesn't really allow you to do that. So I did a huge chunk of the game in VR and it's really nice, but playing it, you know, without it and stuff like that, and sitting here just, you know, relaxing and going through it, it was really nice. So anyways, a lot of different things I'll be doing. The way I'm doing this, I actually go for the 44 Magnum. So by the time I get into the backyard and get to the trailer, I will have enough coins to buy it. And the 44 Magnum helps you shave a lot of time off your boss fights. So it's really handy to have if you're interested in doing a speed run. I've got unlimited ammo. I'll have the X-ray glasses to show me where all the items are at, stuff like that, just in case I accidentally go to blow past one of the coins I need to get the 44 Magnum, which I don't think I will, but, you know, just like having the X-ray glasses on, that way I'll be able to explain to people where items are at and stuff like that. And, like, you wouldn't actually be able to get the 44 Magnum on your first trip to the trailer. If you skip what I'm going to skip towards the beginning, which would be the first videotape, I'm not going to watch that. Obviously, that would take up an enormous amount of time on a speed run. So I'm going to skip that. And what I'm going to use for my ninth coin is actually the dirty coin I got from beating the demo and figuring out all the puzzles and stuff like that. So I'll be able to use that as my ninth coin. So by the time I get to the trailer, I will be able to get the 44 Magnum. That's going to make my boss fights immensely easy. And another really critical thing to do is to, if you're going to do a speed run, meet the requirements and get yourself the circular saw. That thing is just wild, and it takes care of bosses in a pinch. And any enemy that you know is going to be directly in your pathway, the circular saw gets rid of them in a heartbeat. So that's a huge weapon to have on this speed run. But other than that, you know, as we go through, I'll kind of explain why I'm doing this. You know, there's a lot of things I've got going through my head right now, like I'm trying to remember certain points. I got to turn right here, not left, you know, that kind of thing. Got to touch this door, you know, ignore this. So hopefully I don't make any mistakes, which, you know, I'm not perfect, so I'm bound to, but pretty excited for this, man.
All right. Well, give me 1 second here. We're going to switch over scenes. Now, on the bottom of the right of the screen there, obviously, that is Rusty, and this is me on the left bottom. We've had quite a few viewers come in and out already, so without any further ado, if you have any more information, I think we could probably do that after the stream. So it maybe makes a little bit more sense. I myself have never seen this game played. I played the demo briefly, but I'm new to this, so if you're new to this too, we'll be going through the same experience. Also, get interactive on the chat. I'll be following along while he plays. So I think we'll leave it up to Rusty now to go ahead and fire it up anytime he's ready.
Right on. Let's do this.
All right.
Obviously, you're going to play it on easy. It's just to make it the fastest, you know. I haven't tried anything else on normal or hard or anything like that. But easy is obviously the best way to do this. So this first section here, really scripted and really it takes up a lot of your time because, like, you're kind of guided along for a little bit. And the dialogue is classic Resident Evil dialogue. It's terrible.
What up, Globin?
Globin!
You act like you get paid for it or something. Jeez.
Bye, baby.
It's not showing on the list. It's showing active.
No.
You were right. I shouldn't have.
Obviously not going to do that.
Oh, there's no need to check. I was just going to do some dialing in, make sure the audio and video was good to go. You can still do that. Let me know how it sounds.
Feeling like this could be a pretty good run. Hopefully the boss fights work in my favor here.
Yeah, maybe I'll bump it up a little. I did have it set down quite a bit just for the intro.
Here good we call, go. Though. Take off running.
This is the place.
Look at that foliage.
There's the house I'm going to. Can't go in through the front gate. Got to go this way.
Globin says, just wrecked the car into a bush.
Speed anyone that played complete. The demo, that van right there is for the sewer gators, the guys that were going through and videotaping the derelict mansion. Over here we get our first glimpse at Jack. For the record, that guy's an asshole. Here's where you pick up Mia's purse and get her driver's license, but you don't really need to do that. I'm just gonna head right on in. This should look familiar to anyone that played the demo.
Yep.
Dude, wow, off to a great start. Because why not? Well, who farted in the hot tub?
I was just going to say, sorry.
We have the remains of one of the sewer gators. Okay, Mia's in that cell, but we gotta go over here and grab the bolt cutters. This is the part where it kind of has you on rails and can't really do this part any faster than it wants you to.
Ethan?
Are you all right?
You shouldn't be here.
What do you mean? You contacted me.
No, I wouldn't. Did I? Did anyone see you? Did he see you?
Hey, who else is here? What the hell's going on?
Daddy's coming. We need to go.
Daddy?
We need to go now!
Somebody needs to take a shower.
I'll join.
Someplace safe.
You want to tell me what's going on?
There's a couple little things in here that are like you got to stay relatively close to her to until a certain point because like I noticed it kind of glitches out a little bit. And I'll explain that here in a second. But for this part here, you just got to basically follow her. It will not let you walk past her.
What is this place? What'd they do to you?
Not now. We need to get out of here first. I think it's this way.
At this point here, if you stick too close to her as she goes to squeeze through that, it actually sometimes won't trigger the animation for you to go through. So you got to let her go through most of the way, and then you can go up to it.
I remember.
Then you have to get right up
there.
Next to her.
It's there.
Or else she will not walk through this door, so you have to be right on her.
This is it.
And this next part here, I don't really know exactly how to trigger the next point.
There's another door here. I'm sure of it.
You just have to be out of the scene, essentially.
It's not here. It's gone.
So she's going to panic about this door being gone. Just kind of go hang out in here for a little bit. Got some creepy ass dolls up on the shelf. You'll get an audio cue when you know you can go through. Right here.
No, leave me alone!
Door's open. Through here, down to the bathroom. Grab these just in case, and you'll have some more audio cues right here. That's how you know you can continue. Something's wrong with Mia.
This is the one I seen the other day.
Just let her come at you now.
Wait!
Your hand is fucked.
I can hear her. I can feel her clawing her way back inside of me. Get out! Leave me alone! I'm in bad. I deserve this.
Doink!
What the fuck are you, Mia?
locked, can't go through there. Nothing else in here. Basically, I think this is a timed, right here, a triggered event. Look over, there's an axe here. Make sure you grab that ASAP. This is essentially a bunch of striking and blocking. Until we get to this point here. Match R2, and then do this. Okay. Door's still locked, so you're waiting for another audio cue, which will be the telephone. You have to answer this phone call.
You really shouldn't have come here.
Who's this? And what the fuck is going on?
My name is Joey.
Oh, this is where I started.
There should be a way out through the attic.
Okay.
Go there. Now.
Now, this is one of the unavoidable phone calls that it triggers the next part, so you have to listen to it. So, Mia's gone. Axe is still here. We're going to need that for later. Ooh, that's not nice. We still have those bolt cutters, and if you remember on the way in, there was that cabinet with the chain across it. Those bolt cutters are the last thing I selected, so I should be able to just do that. Back to the room that you started in over here, and there's a fuse panel on the wall. Put that in there, that's the fuse for the upstairs stairway.
Ethan, it's okay. It's okay, it's me.
Mm-hmm. You know you didn't. I remember this.
Hurt me.
You shouldn't have done that! It fucking hurts!
Pull the fucking screwdriver out.
Where the hell did she just get that chainsaw?
Probably out of the tool shed.
I didn't need that anyways.
Good thing there's two of them.
Grab that. Come on. That's the kind of shit that hangs you up right there. We're gonna go upstairs. Gotta drop the attic stairs down. Get this here.
You already turned the power on?
No. Found up here, you don't really need, there's a gun in this room here, you don't really need that. It's more of a, it wastes more time than anything. If I do this right, I can take her out quickly, but you gotta get on the ladder and then get right back off. She's about to come through. Oh no, she got up. Try and land headshots. There. You gotta hit her in the head.
At least she's faithful.
And then it's kind of a waiting game. Just kind of chill out here for a second. You'll hear a clunk. That and then.
Welcome to the family, son.
There's Jack.
Seems like a nice guy.
Die on us now. You have work to do.
Check this out. A few staples, good as new. Who needs a doctor?
Put the watch over it, you never know.
There, that's Lucas. He's even more of an asshole.
Who are all you people? Where's Mia?
Eat it. It's good.
Dumb son bitch wasn't no good if it hit him.
Lucas!
Hit boy's got to eat. He got to have his supper. Come here, boy.
That doesn't look good at all.
Shit,
could be a cheese puff.
He's not eating it!
Get the hell up, Marguerite!
I'll make that for him!
Get the hell out of here!
You're a son of a bitch! Oh, I can't believe it, you son of a bitch!
Gosh, she do. She's creeps me out at another level. I can't explain that.
God damn it! Oh, there's that cop again!
Goddamn pigs! I'm coming back for you.
She's just chilling. Closes the doors, your character will kind of glance back towards the center. You can start rocking your way out of the chair. Now all the fun begins. Come out here, work your way down to the end of the hallway here. Jack will show back up. There's a key on that table, you've got to be able to get that.
Thought you just shoot out before dinner was done?
If he takes you down, he'll, like, cut another limb off, and it's just, it kills a lot of time. Keys for this hatch. Come on. The animations of this game take forever. The first coin that I need to get the 44 mag is right here in the lawnmower. Come up in here, you'll get to your first like save room type thing. It'd be a tape recorder for you to save your progress and all that stuff. Phone rings. Gotta listen to this one.
You did good, Ethan.
Zoe, right? What the fuck are you?
Shut up and listen if you want to stay alive. You gotta get out of that house.
And after this phone call, first thing I'll do is go to that item box there and pull out all the stuff that I need.
And that thing on your wrist is a codex. Don't lose it. It's important.
Nice work, Zoe.
Hell of a girl.
Okay, so it tells you everything you got. I want the Albert gun, infinite ammo, maybe that. Circular saw, x-ray glasses, and then I'll grab the dirty coin later. So, the Albert, first thing you do is switch ammo to the enhanced handgun ammo. You're gonna need that stuff for Jack later. Gotta come down here, You have to try and open the door. It won't let you. All the way back here. And you'll hear somebody at the window.
Open up!
It's the cop that they were talking about earlier.
Hey, you gotta help me.
Hold on, back up. Now, sir, do you live here? I mean, is this your property?
What? Me? No. No.
All right. Now, we got several calls about some missing persons lately.
You don't understand. I gotta get out of here.
Calm down.
You're not listening to me. There are crazy people in this house trying to fucking kill me.
Well, all right. Let me tell you this. You don't exactly seem like you're playing with a full deck yourself, all right?
Are you kidding me?
Like I said, we've had several missing persons call. And I can't rule out that an outsider like yourself may not be involved.
Right. I'll tell you whatever you want.
All right. That's more like it. Now, meet me in the garage. We'll talk later.
Hey, wait. You gotta give me your gun.
Yeah. This is funny because the next part here.
Look, officer.
After he says this.
Right. Deputy. You wanna see my name in the obituaries? But you wanna be a hero and save my life.
Like, I thought he was actually gonna give it to him. I'm like, no way.
A fucking pocket knife?
Here. Take it. That's all you're gonna get.
Okay.
Now go. Garage. Now.
Now you need this knife.
What am I gonna do with a knife?
Because apparently you can't pull tape off with your bare hands.
Mm-mm. Nice. You almost pulled a muscle doing that.
I know.
Hey, we gotta get the fuck out of here.
Now first you need to tell me what you're doing out here alone in the middle of the night.
Me? What about you?
No, it's my job. You do your job and tell me. Answer my questions.
I got to experience this next part for the first time in VR, and it was awesome.
Hey, put that door back. Put that door back up.
Wait!
Oh, wow.
See, there's an item there. You got to pick that up. You need that gun. Biggest thing is you got to get Jack in this car. I can never get it to trigger properly, but...
You gotta get him in the car?
Yeah, you gotta get him to go in the car, so I'm just gonna do it the fucking hard way. There we go.
Better start running, boy!
This is what you're trying to trigger the whole time, get the car to ignite. You just gotta basically hold him back and that'll happen. That's all you're really gonna do. Get the other gun out that you picked up from the cop. While you're looking down, a ladder will kind of go down for you off on the side here. You have to have this gun equipped, I believe.
Do I have your attention, boy? You're about to see some wonderful.
Oh, fuck!
And now you're good.
That's pretty cool.
Get this, turn it around, start the screw. You can back out and move the shelf. By the time you get done moving the shelf, you can just double click this real quick and you'll have the piece to open that door. Next coin I need is right there. Ignore the phone call. Grab that. There's that lady again. Creep. They're here. Here. Another coin. Book, open that up. That's what we need right there. Back out the same way you came in. Go to the bathroom. Way past the tub, hit the switch, while it drains, grab this coin, grab the statuette, and now you'll see this guy again.
Think of a dying man, that sure shit beats the hell out of dying.
If you want to keep him off your ass, you can tag him a few times.
As you can see, which in a world...
When we start shaking like that, take a left out of the bathroom, drop back down here. Go to the clock, hang the pendulum, grab this here. Now, when you head this way. Immediately turn around.
You're wasting your time.
I'll go through the kitchen here. Now it's a nice new hole. And go across the way here, and this is where that thing you picked up out of the tub is going to come into play. I went the wrong way. Nope.
Shit. Who builds this shit?
I'm gonna go dump these off real quick. Jack's still on the prowl. Really, I mean, there's a lot of stuff that's pretty awesome in this area here, but I don't really need them for the speed run. Go to this ashtray. There's another antique coin in there. This is the first time you'll encounter a molder.
What the?
I'm gonna go ahead and bypass that guy. Another save room here. Put that away. The car key. This part here, I like to have the circular saw. Just kind of aim high as you come around this corner, hold the left trigger, start cutting. Same thing, you come in here, aim high, start cutting. Trigger the one with the hand and the one on the far right. And that one, stay in the corner, you need that key, grab the key and run.
Doesn't really look like you're running.
Yeah. Brisk walk. Bypass this guy. And hi. Just work your way through here. Basically just skipped a scene too. It involves the cop and Jack and the last piece of the puzzle that I need. But I'm just going to go ahead and grab this thing here. This seems a little suspicious, huh? Get up, run away from him.
Ain't getting away.
Tag him a couple times, switch back to your circular saw and start cutting it up. Head over here. Just basically just hold the circular saw on him. Stay more to this side.
Ooh.
Alright. Got it there. He's done. Basically just mash X on this until the animation kicks in. Drop the broken chainsaw so you don't have two inventory slots taken up. Basically just work your way back to where you came. Instead of going right where you came, you gotta take a left here. Open this up. Right next to this pallet down low, another coin. Over here, this is the key you're gonna need. Back upstairs. Backyard. Take a quick right, go through the bushes. Another antique coin there. There's the trailer. Go in here. I'm dump the Albert gun. Grab the dirty coin. There's a scorpion key. Oop. Shit. Don't need that either. Grab the last coin you'll need off there. Basically sit there and mash X until you run out of those coins and use the dirty coin. Grab the 44 Magnum. Now this is going to save you a lot of time. Phone rings. You have to answer this or else the gate will not unlock.
You made it. You're the first of us to make it this far.
So what is it you need me to do? Is it going to help me get out of here?
Yes. Now listen carefully, Ethan. My family and I, our bodies are contaminated. I can't leave the property unless I get it out. And the same goes for Mia.
Is there a way to get it out?
We need the serum. It should clear whatever this stuff is out of the body. As long as you're not too far gone.
All right. So where is it?
If I knew where one was, I'd already be long gone. But I have a feeling my mother has hidden some inside the old house somewhere.
So if we get this thing, I can help Mia and we can get out of here?
Right. And so can I. The old house
is... See what I mean about how time-consuming these are?
Yeah.
I just hope
so I'm kind of glad you could skip a bunch of them. I didn't know you could skip a whole bunch of them. I was actually listening to them all on my first speed run. Okay. Leave the trailer, head out this way. Boy, another creepy old house. Once you're in, go to this door on the right, use a magnum. Two shots will clear that bug nest out. Two shots will clear that one out. Right, down here, you'll see Mia to the right, but you don't really need to talk to her. Just grab the thing on the table. This door, and my favorite character will show up. At that point, with a bunch of spiders jumping on me, I'd be like, sorry, Mia, and I'd just go home.
That probably looked interesting in VR. Spiders going across your face.
Through here, tag that nest. She'll be right outside this door. I like to just get her out of the picture. Down, and then she'll take off. thing you picked up off that table down there goes here. It's not one of those puzzles. Now, because I carry a few extra things, I gotta run out here and grab that backpack right there. Now, it's a little bit of a time waster, but it's... Nope. Why did it do that? Start heading your way through here. Now, when you play the game normally and stuff like that, you actually experience this whole point twice. One through the perspective of Mia and one, obviously, through Ethan.
Jesus, fuck!
The corner here. Why do people keep lawnmowers in their crawl spaces? I don't understand.
Yeah, I don't follow that either.
It seems like an inconvenient spot for it. Look at that asshole. And that one. Just try and ignore the bastards buzzing around you and stuff like that. They may hit you once or twice, but they're not really going to do anything too crazy. Here, grab his key. Back out the way you came in. Mag makes this so much easier.
All right, little cop.
Once she starts falling like that, just start climbing up. She'll pass right past you and go down. And here, you have to trigger this.
Find a son?
I just got done dealing with your mom and her fucking bugs. Wish you could have warned me.
Sorry about that. What about the serum?
I haven't found any. But I did find out we need to make one. A D-series head and an arm. This can't be right.
A head? I think I have that around here somewhere.
She just keeps heads laying around.
I don't know about the arm, though. Have you searched the whole house?
No, not yet. I still need to check the second floor here.
All right. Check it out. Meet me at the trailer if you find it.
Okay, so for this next part, you have to go all the way around here to the end to that door. Just basically got to wiggle and jiggle it. It's locked. Head back out. So she's gone. I need that lantern.
Yeah, no, they can have it.
Hmm. Now this boss fight is just creepy. Just awful. Gross. She's got a very specific weak point that's in a very weird area.
How long until the boss fight?
Just a minute. There's this jet right upstairs. Now with this boss fight, she's got all these different avenues that she can kind of pop in and out of and stuff like that. If you're looking at any of them, she won't come through there. So you can use that to your advantage to guide her to where you want her to be. A lot of trial and error in the past couple things here. Pops out, run past. Get her in the most open area here. Gotcha! Ah, crap, she's messing me up, dude. Damn it. I blew it. Yeah, I know where she's at. This sucks. She's killed a lot of time here. There we go. There it is. Damn. That screwed me right there, man.
We're fucking stay
in this
dead,
spot
okay?
Here. Grab the lantern, go through this door. Back out here. Escape. Just kind of wait for this to fall away. Lantern. Gonna have to find a health item because that boss fight just screwed me hard. Here, instead of just pulling on the lever, you gotta hang a lantern from it. Found the arm.
Oh, God. I guess this is it.
There'll be a dude right out here. Take him out. Another guy here, you can just go right past him. Hopefully this last dude doesn't mess me up. Ooh, I missed him. Whatever. Just run! Once you get out of their area, they'll just go away. Go right past that. Drop down. put some stuff away. Don't have to answer that call. But unfortunately, I have to take the time out to use that. I'm gonna head back down to that basement where I fought Jack. Where he had that goofy ass saw thing. This is going to be one of those instances where having the circular saw would be handy, but he evaded me last time, so let's see what... Bam!
Wow.
Here's our cop buddy from earlier.
Well, alright.
There's right a sign to the left that tells you to reach down there.
Sorry.
Snake key. Through here. Bypass all the molded. Snake key here. Hurry up and open the door. This brings you back out the way you came in. Now there's going to be that guy there. There's going to be a couple molded out in the main area here. You'll want to take care of them. That's where the Magnum comes in handy, if you can land a decent shot. And you go up this way. There's his buddy. Head over here. Use the snake key again. Go in, go right to the lamp, push the button. I don't remember the exact thing for this. There it is. Just gotta get it close, doesn't have to be perfect. We have ourselves one of two key cards we need. Grandma's room over here. Another little security blanket there, more items. You go to this little clock puzzle here. Basically, it says same as all the other clocks. It says 10:15. This area. Just get the fuck out of here. Now, this is kind of a pain in the ass, this next part. Ignore the phone call, go out here, you'll see four-legged molded. Take him out, there'll be another one around the corner here. This dude screwed me up last time. There we go. Somebody's having a party. Now this is like one of my favorite sections of the game, just because this focuses more heavily on the puzzle aspect of it and all that stuff. But you have to watch this video.
My thing work. Ethan.
How we doing back there, Nate?
Ethan.
We're alive and streaming.
Hold on. I got something for you. Looky, looky what I've got.
Is that a brisket?
You know what this is for? You know what Zoe wants to do with this? She thinks this thing is special. No, Ethan. That ain't special. This right here is special. You see, Ethan?
Yeah.
Not everybody wants to turn back the clock. What? What, Evelyn? I'm just trying to show him. I'm just trying to show him not everybody wants to go back to how things were. There's a stupid bitch. She doesn't understand that I don't want to go back to how things were before my father found y'all. Not everybody wants to turn back the clock. So, Ethan, Ethan, you can crawl around underneath that filthy, rotten house all you want looking for them ingredients, but you ain't gonna find a goddamn thing, Ethan. You'll need that serum? Ooh, baby. You're gonna have to come through me. You hear? Now, come on, Ethan. What do you say?
Asshole.
Fuck!
Alright, head on into the freaking puzzle house. This first part's not really that bad. Come and crawl under the tripwire, or the bomb. Same thing over here. Crawl under this one. Best thing to do here is to take these ones out. One there. One there. Hopefully I get lucky here. Yeah, first aid. That one will blow up. Just don't take a hard left through this door. That one up, stay the right side of the doorway here.
Guess I'm gonna have
I know. Fucking password, right? why don't you try 0814? No. 0621. No, it's 0514. Well, come on, take a chance, you never know.
Just put in any one of them, doesn't really matter.
Top,
fall. I'll open this side. Just keep running down here. Just ammo. There'll be a wire across here. You got duck under. There's something coming behind you, but just ignore it. Pretty much bypass everything. There'll be a guy to your right here, a crawler right there, and then this guy that usually hits me. Ah, he missed. Right on. Drop straight down. Battery.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the bonfire.
too.
He is down. He will blow up. Don't get too close to him. Now for that door, it usually retains the same password, but if you think you're going to be sly and put it in on the first try, it changes it on you. Go through here, that guy will have it, but... So, it will always be the same, 1408. Before you go in, you gotta empty your inventory. You will not be able to get this door unlocked without doing that. Nope. Anyone familiar with the Resident Evil franchise will recognize those sound effects. Grab the candle. There's a lot more to this puzzle in a different scene, but for this one here, we're going to do it the quickest way possible. Just basically run through there. The whole goal is to light the candle and put it on the birthday cake over there. There's a lot more, like I said, involved in it, but for this run here, you can, if you know the, you know, how to get through everything, the passwords and all that stuff, you can just breeze right through it. Candle right over here. Come over here, and for each one of these, just push down 5 times. Come on. Wow.
Loser.
Valve handle. Back through the shower again. Turn the water off. Want to relight your candle. Go put it on the cake. Happy fucking birthday. Tear this right off the wall because he is not happy with you and he basically throws dynamite down. Go ahead and stuff that back there. If you stand directly in front of it, it will knock you on your ass, so stand off to the side. Head through. He kind of sounded like Chris from Family Guy there. Now you got the head.
Fine.
You get all your shit back. You're going to want the crank and the arm and the head in your inventory right now. Come out here. Use the crank. Another spot around this way you have to use the crank on. So now that's up there. You're gonna have a four-legged mold that pops out. You don't want to deal with that asshole. There we go. Just forget about those guys and go right. Circular saw is pretty handy for this next part. Give it to him. I have another guy drop down. Oh, no way. Wow, can't believe that didn't kill him. Yeah, whatever. So now you have both ingredients. Go right to Zoe here.
Zoe? Zoe,
not now. We don't have the time. Do you have both ingredients?
Right here. There should be enough, right?
If we make them fast enough, my father and Lucas aren't far away. He's coming. Daddy's coming.
Now this boss fight could screw me up. It could waste a lot of time, but hopefully it goes really well.
So after we make the serum, what's next?
There's a boat outside. We'll take it through the swamp. But none of us will get very far without the serum.
Kinda, there we go.
Hey, one of those is mine.
Get your ass back to the house.
Hi, Jack.
I will deal with you later.
All right. Always mess this part up.
Oh, no.
This is getting old, Jack.
That one. Over the other side. Hope he doesn't hit me. Yep. This is the part where it kind of screws you up because it doesn't go. There you go. Now you just wait for him. That did not go well at all. Dead.
Now, I've seen everything.
Or is he?
Ethan, this way.
Nothing on you.
Use the serum on him.
You want me to cure him?
All right, we are done with Jack.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Come on, he's waiting for us.
Okay. Now you have one serum left, and you're going to be given a choice here. Between me and Zoe, pick Mia for a speed run.
I had to use one of them. There's only one left.
If you pick Zoe, Mia will get pissed off. You'll have to fight her later, and that's just more time added to your speed
run. There can't just be one left. What the hell are we gonna do now? It's fine. It was just thinking I could escape.
But Zoe...
Go! Both of you, just go!
Come with us. I'm sure there's someone who can help.
This is my home. Apparently I belong here.
I'll send help.
Don't bother. There won't be anyone left to help!
Basically just play the waiting game. Now this next part, which gives you most of the storyline and how this all came about, but
thank you.
It's like my least favorite section. It's more like a lot of backtracking, going back over the same stuff you've done over and over again and stuff like that, and a couple different scenarios, but it's just a pain in the ass. It's relatively quick to get through, but
you had something to do with all this, didn't you?
Wonder how we're doing on time. Not
bad. I just want to know the truth.
Ethan, I honestly don't remember.
Try.
I think I'm roughly about 7 or 8 minutes behind the world record right now.
Is that the boat? How the fuck did that get here?
We're gonna need a bigger boat.
You're okay. The hell was that? What the fuck?
Messi?
What is that?
So did you hear about boost mode for the PS4 Pro? Nate?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, I posted it on Twitter.
Ethan?
Basically, you're playing as Mio right now. This beginning section is pretty linear. You're basically going to have to go in the ship to proceed. But I don't want to go in the ship. I can't even imagine what you would find in here. Bit of a flashback, so you know Mia's been here before.
What was that?
She's still having a hard time remembering, though. Have to go to this door first. Realize it's locked. Turn around. Another flashback.
They're all dead. Danger, Luke. What the fuck are you talking about? She killed them all. Fuck. What the hell is going on? We need some weapons. Is there any weapons on this ship? I don't know, but... Look, let's go this way. Maybe we can get out of here.
Yep. Don't even worry about any of these doorways here. Why do games gotta use creepy little kids?
Kids.
What the fuck of a ladder?
No shit. All that just to drop down.
Oh. Should have built the tunnel. Go away.
What are you talking about?
You said!
Okay.
Wait!
Go to the right. Through here. Trying to grab a fuse. Molder will drop down. Always hits me, son of a bitch. Second floor door. It's locked anyways. Up to the third floor. There she is. Now you have to watch this video.
Watch it. What? Why?
Load times on these videos are just ridiculous.
Alan, you're getting worse.
She must have infected me during the attack. Not too far. But it serves me right. It's my fault she got out.
Yeah, it is your fault. But that doesn't mean I'm gonna let you die.
She didn't attack you?
It's part of her imprinting protocol. I can't believe this is happening.
Here. Take it. It has her tissue sample. You find her. You fix this.
Okay, Evie. Where are you?
Okay, grab a couple things. Ooh. Shit around.
She's close.
Here.
She's not. Damn. I'll have to reset.
How's it going?
You can call on your Apple Watch there.
Far more in excess of her body mass.
I don't know, I thought I seen a headphone jack.
All right. We need to find her, and fast. This is getting out of hand.
Agreed.
Oh, I get it. This guy will drop in. it down to S2.
Gee, Nightbot. Nice of you to show up finally.
Oh, I missed. Just kind of keep him distracted.
Appreciate the retweet. Thank you.
Don't hit me, don't hit me, don't hit me. All right. Aw, oh, come on. I've had him hit me twice in a row before. See those three bubbles back there? Through, mash X. Only grab one of these.
Are you mad at me, Mommy?
No, Stevie, I'm not mad. Wait, what did you call me?
I don't want to live at the lab anymore. I want a house. And I want you to be my mommy.
Okay, Evie. I'll be your mommy. Just come back.
Evie, wait!
Did you find her?
Yes, but she ran off. She's making more friends, Alan. Those things are everywhere.
I told you so.
Are you okay?
You're just worried about getting Evelyn back.
Hey, come through here. Hit again, so I'm gonna have to take one of these guys out. Damn it. Alright, you missed. Okay, now you're gonna want the circulars off of this here. Aim high! Kind of guides you along and shows you the only choices you have. You're on S2, the only option you have is 3. Elevator will break down, so you gotta pry the door open.
System has been engaged.
Ooh, nice. That worked out good.
You get here?
Where's Evie?
She's out of control. Without the treatments, she's deteriorating.
Well, it's a good thing we're already dying.
Don't say that.
She trusts you. That little bitch, she never trusts. Okay. Wait. Evie! No, Evie! Evie!
Alan, listen!
I didn't mean to call you that!
She's trying to take control! You have to fight her!
Ah!
She doesn't like name calling. Right. So now after you wake up, it shows you how Mia got infected. Going through Nora Allen. There's a computer.
Looks a lot like Windows Media Player to me.
This right here shows you. Basically, it's like the flashback of like the time when she recorded the video at the beginning, you know?
Yep.
You were right. I did lie to you. I shouldn't have. All I can say is that if you get this, stay away. Forget that you ever knew me. Have a good life.
Alright, get away from the computer. Here.
We'll be together forever.
Skip the movie. Times, dude, are just awful. Mine doesn't populate, so
a lot of retweets and stuff aside from yours and everything.
It's nice.
Now do you remember?
Yes, Evelyn. I remember.
Can we be a family like before?
No, Evie. We can't be a family. We were never a family. We will never be a family.
Then I don't need you anymore.
Okay, come on. Elevator.
Elevator go up.
Yep. Pull this bad boy open. Head in and go straight up this 14-mile long ladder.
Oh, another one?
Yeah. It's even worse than before. Up, just to go down. Here, grab this giant fucking wrench. Pry this open. You're back on top of the elevator. Wrench. As soon as you drop down, head towards this, mash circle to go down to the first level. Hopefully beat this guy. point or is confused by your presence. This four-legged molded has a tendency to mess me up.
Yep. Not too bad.
There was a fuse that was put there in that video. Okay, so now I'm up. This way. Go right, not left. Grab my shit.
Can't say shit on stream.
Yeah. Unlock this door. Ah! At least I caught it now. I had a feeling that was going to be the thing that screwed me up. I knew it. I couldn't get through it without one mistake.
What was it?
I need that corrosive for a door later. Gotta be relatively quick. I'll call him Fought Busted. Those guys are awful. They can hit you from like anywhere in the room. They'll follow you on a sprint. The cable there, fuse there. Madhouse, those things will kill you so many times.
Bubble gum?
Oh, no way! I'm stuck! What am I stuck on? That's great. Always just run right through there.
Ethan.
All right.
Ethan. Ethan. Hey, shh. I know. I'm not going to hurt you. Hell, I never would have if I could have helped you.
What do you mean?
I'm no killer, son. Neither is Marguerite, nor my boy Lucas. Or even Zoe here. That girl, Evelyn. She did this.
What the hell is she? Now, what did she do to you?
She infected us with her gift. That's what she calls it.
I found a busted out tank in the bayou. Everything changed after that.
So she infects you and then she takes control?
No. Not exactly, son. She just... she forces her way into your mind, your soul. You can't fight back. You are connected to her, and you can't resist the urge to... Oh, you're a different person after that.
Just like Mia. So Mia sent me that message because of Evelyn.
Listen, the girl just wants a family of her own. She's the key. All right? You find her.
I guess the next wave of DLC will have some stuff in it that kind of explains how Jack and his family all encountered her and stuff like that and got infected and everything, so that's going to be pretty neat. This is the part here where if you had picked Zoe, you come out of this and you have to fight Mia.
Remember?
Mia, how?
There's no time. You have to get out of here and find her. Here, take this.
What? Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Saving your life. You need to go. I won't be able to resist for much longer.
Creepy little thing.
No.
Now go kill that little bitch.
No. No. Mia! No!
Alright, home stretch, man.
Okay, you little bitch. Where the fuck are you?
Hungry? Why imagine how terrible that would smell.
Well, get that candle.
Oh, I was just going through this for a time. I'm going, don't get the water in your mouth. Don't get the water in your mouth. yeah, sure. You got water? Yeah. Alright, here. Make sure when you come here, through here, grab this. I'll show you. You're gonna want the rifle max, which is ammo, and switch ammo types on this thing. You want the neuro rounds. Thank you, sir. Here, these guys. Start the elevator. Amazon. been molded. Oh, there we go. Get rid of that shit. Go through here, just take a hard right, ignore anything that's starting to chase after you. Up the hill, approach the cart from the left because you can't go to the right side. Just start mashing X. Anything that was chasing you gets hit. Except for that guy. How the hell did he hit me?
Lies.
Now, first time I did this, dude, I did not see this bomb here. I ran into that, and then I came up and I knifed that box, and that also has an explosive in it. So I was, like, almost dead. I was pissed. Come in here. You gotta use that sample that she gave you. Next part, you can bypass a lot of these enemies, but if you have the 44 Magnum, it can be made a little easier, but still sucks.
You know, worse than little kids is little kids with creepy singing.
Very reminiscent of Fear.
Griffin and I talk about that all the time. That game was so great.
So basically just get people out of your way with this thing. If it doesn't kill them, it'll at least knock them out of your way for you. Oh, what a miss.
They're not hitting them.
This part is critical here. You need to have a neural round loaded as you approach this ladder. You have two of the fat guys that puke. You want to shoot a neural round at them, climb up because they will knock you off this ladder. Hopefully that gave me enough time. Right on. Here. Through the door. And we're back in the basement.
Where is it?
The original house.
It's not here. It's gone. It's gone.
Gotta head around this way.
Slight chill factor.
You're gonna be one of us.
I'm not playing.
So now she's really pissed.
No!
At this point, she sent Mia after you a bunch with a chainsaw. Head upstairs. See Mia hopefully glitch out. Yep. Alright. Now run through here and you'll see Evelyn.
Get away!
You have to block these. Once you see her charge up like that, you gotta block. Once you get to her, you'll inject her.
No!
Oh. Look who it was the whole time.
Shut up.
Vampire is that good. Don't get it in your mouth.
It hurts! It hurts! It hurts! Damn you! Damn you all to hell!
Now your trusty 44 Magnum will be your best bet here. Picks you up and you look at her again, let her hit you twice and then shoot at her.
I just wanted a family.
This is where you're actually first introduced to that Albert gun. It's got anti-POW rounds in it. I wonder if he's got time to take a phone call.
Grandma, not right now.
Kinda got my hands full. Just start plugging away. Go.
144.59.
Had a couple mistakes there. It kind of cost me a little bit of time. But like I said, man, those load screens are just ridiculous. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm pretty sure that's what's eating up a lot of my time. Yeah, that's my new fastest right there, actually.
Well, we did what we had hoped to. What's if you had one thing in the entire gameplay there that you could change, what would it be?
In the gameplay?
Yep.
Honestly, I would put more of a focus on puzzles. Like, as you can tell, I mean, like, initially when you first go through it, you're not familiar with it, you know, it takes you a minute just because there's a lot of, you know, just going and finding what you're looking for. You know, once you know what you're looking for, you see the result here, an hour and 44 minutes, you know. I wish there was more of a focus on the puzzle aspect of it. I wish I could take you through that birthday scene to show you how elaborate that was originally, you know, because it was actually really, really well done. And then once they put out this this bedroom DLC, it was like, yeah, man, holy shit, I wish they would focus more on that. They're obviously really good at what they do. I just wish they would have done more of it, you know. But other than that, I mean, I thought it was really good from start to finish when I first played it through, very well paced. The only thing I don't like is when you're first going through, your combat isn't really designed for those boss fights. Like, the movements are clunky and slow and stuff like that. They're made easy when you have weapons like that, but the first time you go through, it's just really frustrating, just because it's just time consuming, a lot of trial and error and stuff like that, and it just doesn't seem like the combat and the boss fights are like compatible with each other. You know, it's just overly frustrating when it doesn't have to be. But other than that, everything was. I mean, I like what they're doing with the franchise now. I like how they're just pumping DLC out, really solid DLC too. I mean, the game's only been out for what, like 2 weeks? They already have their first batch of DLC out, the next one's coming, then they got some free DLC that's coming out here shortly too. So, I mean, yeah, good on them. But
right on. Well, for anyone that watches this after the fact, that was strictly just a speed run of Resident Evil 7. Trying to beat his personal best, which he did by around a second. So
yeah, roughly.
So that was pretty cool. Anyhow, if you did stop in at all, appreciate it. We're going to